It's an opportunity for people to save a child's life, and all you have to do is volunteer time for an organization called Feed My Starving Children. It's an organization that packs millions of meals each year. We'll talk to the site supervisor for Feed My Starving Children in a moment, but first, here's a little more about what the organization is about.
When I say I'm hungry, what does that mean to you? I think that if we really thought about hunger on a global scale, the reality of that is more than we can imagine or would ever want to accept. The fact is that one child every 5 seconds dies from a hunger-related cause. That's like 18,000 kids per day. That just blows my mind. How is it that we've become okay with that, that we're comfortable with that? I think it's easy to let that fact just pass us by unless we put a face or a name with that number. And then that number becomes somebody's daughter or son or somebody's grandbaby or brother or sister. I don't think any of us would look a starving child in the eye and say, I won't help you, and then walk away.
Feed My Starving Children is a Christian organization. We produce a nutritious food that we send to starving children in 67 countries around the world.
They backed up a big semi-trailer full of the ingredients and the equipment that's needed to pack.
We bring all of the raw ingredients. We bring boxes, we bring bags, we bring pallet jacks.
We supply the tables and trash bins, but other than that, really everything was brought to us.
The first thought that crossed my mind was, we can do this.
We got churches from several denominations, public school. We've got a Spanish club from one of the high schools around here. It's just amazing. A couple of Gap stores are coming, and it's, you know, the word gets around. It's a wonderful event.
It doesn't matter how old or how young you are. Everybody has some gift that they can give.
You get high school kids, you get grade school kids, families. You get the whole works here. It's amazing.
Our food was scientifically designed to restore a child from malnutrition to health.
With me now to talk about the group's mission is Janine Skinner, site supervisor for Feed My Starving Children in Tempe, Arizona. Thanks for joining us, Janine.
Thank you.
Let's talk just a little bit about the national organization and how old it is and how it got started, and then we'll focus on Arizona.
Wonderful. We're an organization based in Minneapolis in the Twin Cities area. We've been around for about 25 years. The organization basically started because a gentleman went on a trip to Honduras and saw the tremendous need and really felt like he needed to help. He worked with food scientists back in Minnesota to create kind of a superfood that's specifically designed to meet the nutritional needs for malnourished children and to bring them back to health.
And then he got people involved all over the country.
Right.
Arizona, though, this is a relatively new activity. What, about 5 years?
Yes, we've been working. We started doing mobile packing events here in the state, and about a year and a half ago, we had a site donated to us, which was quite a blessing.
Mobile packing, meaning you would go, what, from one church to another, perhaps?
Right. We would bring everything to the church. They would host the event, provide the volunteers, and provide the funding to pay for the meals that we were packing.
And now you mentioned you got at least a temporary site, now a permanent one. Let's talk about that.
Terrific. So we basically started the temporary site just to see what kind of support we would have here in the state. And it has been a really grassroots movement that has just grown virally. It's been wonderful. So we opened on the weekends at this donated space, and pretty soon we were basically turning volunteers away. Our site was booked 6 to 9 months in advance. We couldn't even handle all the volunteers. So we have now become a permanent site, and just recently, as of this March, we've extended to full-time. So we are open, now we're open Tuesdays through Saturdays each week, 21 packing sessions per week. So it's a tremendous amount of growth from weekends to that point.
And you mentioned that we've got some pictures on the screen as we're talking. Is this the local or the national?
Yeah, these are pictures of folks packing, and I believe these pictures may have been taken in Minnesota.
And then
our site looks just like this.
And I know we have some of the local volunteers. What is it that they actually do? There was a mention in the short video intro of the scientific composition of these packets. I assume they're all the same.
They are all the same, yes.
And what do
we
they
have
consist
we have
of?
four ingredients. So the primary ingredient is rice. We also have dehydrated soy for protein and dehydrated vegetables. And then the flavoring, it tastes like chicken, but it's vegetarian, so it's culturally acceptable worldwide. And it's a powdered mix that has 20 vitamins and minerals. And that's kind of that key ingredient that provides the vitamins and minerals necessary to make the kids, to bring the kids to the complete health.
And speaking of the kids, I know we've got some pictures of them receiving mm-hmm. the food. And we'll have them on the screen as we talk. Now, Arizona's focus is Latin America?
We ship to the Philippines as well, but we do, because of our proximity, we do ship to Mexico, Honduras, Guatemala, Nicaragua.
Total of 67 countries was mentioned in the video.
Right, around the world, correct.
And how does it work out in terms of how you coordinate the efforts here in Arizona with those of the recipients?
You know, we do our piece, which is providing the meals, and we do it really well. We use volunteers to hand pack the meals. We give our meals away for free to the mission partners that we work with. They handle the shipping piece. Our meals have a 99.97% success rate to get in country where they need to go. And that's because we're not doing that piece of it. We're handing that off to the mission partners who live there, work there, and know those routes.
Now, you talk about getting to the people who need it. That's obviously been a big issue in troubled parts of the world,
right,
where the food is not getting through. Any of those issues for your organization?
No, like I said, we have a 99.97% success rate of shipments arriving over 25 years.
Everywhere in the world that,
right,
that you operate.
It's an incredible success
and
rate.
Are you avoiding some of the trouble spots in the world? Or
no, not at all. Not at all. We're shipping meals to North Korea. We were helping with the Horn of Africa this past fall, and it's definitely something, again, because of our model with our mission partners being in country, that I think works really well.
Now, obviously, from everything you've said and from the video, it's clear this is a very volunteer-driven effort.
Absolutely.
So let's talk about that. How do you get the volunteers, and what is it that they do?
So our volunteers, when they come to pack with us, when they arrive, we start with an orientation that has a video. We're very education-focused, so we really want to let people know, especially the youth that come to volunteer with us, you know, what world hunger is really all about, and kind of help them to understand how lucky we are to live here in the United States, because we're all so much more fortunate than the people that we're serving. Then we take them in and do a real brief orientation on how to pack the meals. It's sort of assembly line fashion. We can handle volunteers as young as 5, and we also have seated positions for folks who can't stand for the 2-hour packing session. Then we put them to work, and we just have them pack for the next hour and a half or so. We play lots of really fun music. It's very lively, it's really fun, it's entertaining, it's competitive. And at the end of that time, we do a little wrap up. And that basically consists of giving them their statistics so they know how many meals they packed at that packing session and how many kids that'll feed for a year. We even serve them a sample of the food at the end of the packing session. And I've just found we don't do any advertising, so it's basically word of mouth. We've had about 55,000 volunteers join us so far since we've begun in Arizona. And, you know, we have not sought out those volunteers. They've been coming to us because the people who come to pack with us want to come back. They want to bring their friends, their family, their coworkers, their school, their church. And it's just viral that way. It's wonderful.
On the screen, we have a website where people, I assume, can go to and get
right,
more information.
FMSC.org.
Would that also tell them how they volunteer?
Absolutely. Volunteer registration is online.
And in terms of growth for the future, you and I were talking off camera about some of the statistics. You've got, what, about 55,000 volunteers, counting each volunteer
right,
per day.
Right, so far. Yeah, so we've packed about 12 million meals in Arizona so far. Our goal for this new year with the growth is 9 million meals at our Tempe site. We also have a vision for expanding here in the Valley. The need is so great. 18,000 children die of starvation every single day, so we can't stop. We need to pack more meals. And there's also a great need in our community to provide this kind of a unique volunteer experience. So we are hoping to be able to open a second site sometime in the next 2 years here in Arizona. And our goals for that site would be to have a site big enough to pack 25 million meals a year. And that would provide that volunteer opportunity for about 115,000 Arizonans each year.
And we're almost out of time, but I assume the source of funding, a big part of it, is donations.
Absolutely.
People can figure out how to give if they also go to the website.
Absolutely. You can donate online as well.
Very good. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
To talk about this wonderful project.
Thank you.